Okay, so back to 2016, I'm using, that time I'm just using my iPhone to take the to document my case. So that time I didn't use an accessory, so I can't get a clear view or nice picture. So if after 1 year I get my DSLR, so I start using my DSLR as some accessory to document my case. So actually my restoration doesn't improve, just to more detail to see the, so I can I know where to improve. Okay, so why we practice dental photography? So to pattern, show off, and become famous. So after 1 year of practicing dental photography, here are some of my opinions about dental photography. So first about treatment planning and diagnosis. So when you guys face across this kind of cases, a big class, you know, class two cavities. So when you just remove all the caries, you guys will suddenly become blank. How should I view all the anatomy? So maybe before that, after you do E&D, you take a photo, then you can draw some lines, so you have some reference lah. So you can do a better restoration lah. I did it badly, so I didn't show out the box. Okay. So after you learn your dental photography, the next thing you can learn is the digital smile design. So it's some kind of template. So maybe if you guys are interested, I can do it in the other lecture. So it's actually basically a template to design your tooth, how you want to build out your tooth with either composite or crown or veneers and anything. So, or you can do your shade selection also. This is a composite button, so you can see A2, A3, the translucent shade. So you can see the A2 is actually matching the tooth. So you can, because sometimes our eyes will get tired or we can like get perceived by some colors. So a photograph is actually a more accurate device. So the second thing is patient communication. So patient communication, we know that actually Malaysian patients, they won't come to you if they don't have pain. So when they come to you, you tell them that you got many caries, they won't care unless you show them their photo. So you can tell, if one patient comes and comes, you see your tooth very black already, charm already. So, most, because I now what I'm practicing is after the first time the patient comes, I do the E&D, then I took a few of pictures like those occlusal view, the frontal view. After I finish the E&D, I will bring my patient in front of my laptop, I'll show them, Mr. So you have this few problems, so you have to fix your teeth, if not you're like that. So far, the patient is more compliant with these photos. So far, all my patients are coming back. Okay, sometimes I also miss out something. When I'm doing the E&D, I have a bad habit. Like, I will keep checking the occlusal part, I will forget the buccal part. So sometimes, there's one time I show my patient this the photo, and the patient asks me, Bodhi, what is this? So I pretend I already know lah. Oh, this one is a cervical aberration, so you have to do do a restoration like that. So this one will let you to review back your case and so maybe you have something to so you won't miss anything. So you can learning through your observation. So after you document your case like this case, clinically I saw it, very nice. But after I take a photo, upper knee. So this kind, and you see the incisor edge is like not in a straight line. So my next case, I will be more careful on this part lah. So I will like take note on this, so I will repeat the same mistake lah. So this is one of my cases. Both restoration are done by me. This one, you see, the shape is sucks, anatomy is sucks. So after I do my cases, I review back, then I know what I have done wrong, then after that I call my patient to do it again, so it's become better. So yeah, you also can document some of your cases, so for you to review back and look back what's your mistake. So 6 help from the pro. So sometimes you don't have enough knowledge to manage some cases. So if you just ask like doctor or you just want to show ask opinion from your friends, when you just talk, they can't really get you. So if you show them a picture, it's much easier. They can say, oh, like that. So you can do what treatment you can do what. So this is the after. Okay. So lab communication. This one is actually quite important. So we also use the smile design. So actually you can plan it. with the digital smile design, you can play how your tooth you want to look like, what's the shape. So you can show it to the technician, they will know what you want. Because actually we can't depend all of our cases to the technician. We can't just send our impression and send our cast that you do for me, lah. You are the dentist, you are not the technician, not the technician responsible to a patient, you are the one who is responsible. So yeah, you also can do a shape selection. So okay, how can we start on dental photography? You can use DSLR or mirrorless camera. So, or you can use a smartphone. So, if you want to do dental photography, first you need a camera body. Just now Ian has recommended a few. Then a macro lens, because we want to capture a small object, we need a macro lens. And we need a flash and other accessories. So we start on the DSLR dental photography first. So for the camera body, you can choose either Canon or Nikon, so it doesn't matter, they are just the same actually. So for macro lens, actually you don't have much choices. You only have, for Canon, you don't have a 60mm and a 100mm lens. So if you want to take dental photography, you have to choose the lenses more than 60mm, the focal length must more than 60mm. Because if you take the lenses less than 60mm, you will be very close to a patient. When you take a photography, you like just in front of your patient, is not really convenient and not very nice. So for girls or someone who is short, so I would recommend a 60mm lens because it's easier to use and actually it's more lightweight. Like this is just 300 grams, and compared to 100mm, it's 600 grams. So it's very heavy, so it's hard to use also. So the Nikon, they also have a same 60mm, 105mm. You also can choose the Tamron or the Tokina, both are the good lenses. So yeah, they are cheaper than the Nikon and Canon. So you guys, I'm using the Tamron 90mm, it's quite good actually. So the flash, so you can choose a ring flash or a twin flash. Twin flash is gone.
Sample.
So why we are not using the pop-up flash in your camera body? First, you can't control the flash, and the second thing is you can't get an even exposure of the image. So sometimes maybe you can just concentrate the pop-up flash. You only concentrate the light on the center of the photo, and the surrounding is just dark. So we recommend a ring flash. So a ring flash or twin flash. So you can see this picture is taken by a ring flash, and this picture is taken by a twin flash. You can see that the picture taken by a ring flash is actually more down, and this one is like more lively. And you can see that with a twin flash, you can see the line angle of the tooth. So it's actually more aesthetic lah. But one thing is, twin flash is more technique sensitive, and is more expensive lah. If you only use for document your normal case or normal procedure, I would recommend a ring flash because it's lighter and easier to use. But if you want to do like competition or very aesthetic anterior case, the twin flash definitely is the best. Accessory, the intraoral mirror, contraster and shape shifter. If you want to do dental photography, these three things is a must for you guys only. So the intraoral mirror, actually there are dental suppliers who selling this thing, but actually we don't need buy from them because they sell it very high price. We just go to Taobao. But contrast is quite expensive, but you can just DIY yourself or you can buy from them. Okay, mirrors, camera, then dental photography. Mirrors, we can have the Sony. those mirrors cameras are body. One thing is, just like as I already explained, mirrors camera is more expensive, and their lens, there are less choices of their lens. So one method I found, if you have a mirrors camera and you have a prime lens, or actually with your kit lens also can, you just buy a macro extension tube from Taobao. Just buy then you adapt it. You can take a macro photo. You can take a macro photography. But one thing I don't like about this macro extension is you only can focus on certain distance. Mean you have to like adjust your camera to a certain distance. You only can take a photo. It's not so convenient, but more budget lah. This extension tube is cost you around 100 to 200 ringgit. So yeah, can consider about that. Mobile phone dental photography. So if you really don't want to buy a camera, you can use your mobile phone, no problem. So you have to buy this one mobile phone ring light, or you should buy the water. So the ring flash lah. So somehow I never tried before, but I saw people use lah. They say useful lah. So yeah, if you want to do a mobile phone dental photography, first you have to, when you take a photo, you have to zoom into half first at least to take a better photo lah. But you need a flash lah. You see this one without flash is a very very noise those image. So yeah, you need to get a 自拍无光的. Okay, so all this thing is a lot of money. So actually you can buy your stuff from Taobao, the Kia DSLR, or even you can find a lot of second stuff from Buddha.my. So yeah, this is my set. Actually all of them are second hand, but the flash is a new one. My Canon 550D is 800, Tamron 800, the flash 390, so total is less than 2000. So okay, it's actually not that expensive, right? You can first buy the camera body, then after a few months taking Maggie, buy the lens, then finally the flash. Yes, and then on the camera side. So this is a setting for the camera dental photography. So we always try to fix your ISO to 100 to 200. We don't want to exceed more than 200 because your image will wound in eyes. I would recommend just 100 lah. At the most condition, if you really can't do anything on other setting, you only increase to 200. Shutter speed always fix to 1.0125. Never lower or no need to be higher. The aperture for intraoral, you have to make it at least 20 and above. Why? Because we taking the dental photography, we need to everything to be focused. If something less than 20, you only focus on one spot and everything will be blurred, so no point lah. So if you want to take portraits, I would recommend like f5 or 6 will be okay. White balance, actually you can make it auto, but I not so recommend lah, because auto sometimes your camera is too clever, so they will make it different color, so it's actually not so good lah. We just fix it to the flash setting. Focus, single point, autofocus. Your flash, you always turn it to manual mode because you can also turn it to the E2PR mode, which is auto mode, so manual mode. Actually the flash is very, we don't have a fixed setting for the flash, it just depends on, because it actually depends on what kind of lenses you use, what the distance of your object and your lenses. So you have to know that the larger the number is actually the weaker the flash. So like this one, 1.0 flash is just nice, 1.0/60 is underexposed already, 1.0/1 is overexposed. So when you take photo, you can just adjust lah, adjust see which setting is the best for you lah. So yeah, we'll show you how to take the dental photograph. Contact me or
me.
Me or me.